Let's start. This is the chapter Fushi and the Parrot. Okay, Fushi and the Parrot. We have already done before and we are doing it once again as a revision, right? So first of all, what is written here? New words. H-U-N-G-R-A. We have already done the new words before, okay? But once again we will do P-A-W-S, pause. R-A-I-N-I-N-G, raining. H-E-A-R, here. W-A-I-T, wait. These are the new words from the chapter. It is raining. Push. The cat is feeling hungry. There is no food. There are no rats. He looks here and there. He sees a parrot sitting on a tree. He requests the parrot. What happened? It was raining. Okay. Push, the cat was feeling very hungry. Means bhook lagna. There is no food. There is no food around. There are no rats. He looks here and there. After that, what he sees? A parrot sitting on a tree. He requests the parrot. Push, Mr. Parrot, you sing well. Please sing a song for me. What does the push saying to the parrot? You sing very well. You sing a song for me. Parrot, feeling very happy. Yes, yes, la la la, dum de dum. After listening this, the parrot started singing for push. Okay, let's see then what happened after that. Next, push, I cannot hear you, Mr. Parrot. Please come near me. No, no, Mr. Push, you may eat me. Push, no idea. I am an old cat. I have no teeth. I cannot eat you. See, the cat was making fool to parrot that I'll not eat you. I'll not do you any harm. So what was the push doing? I cannot hear you. Come near me and sing. Okay. Then the push said, no, no, I'm an old cat. I have no teeth. I cannot eat you. So, the cat is telling, I am a very old cat, I have no teeth, I cannot eat you. Parrot, then here I come, la la la, dum dum dum, tarala. Push jumps on the parrot and holds him in his paws. See, the fear which was that the parrot came near him. And what does the push does? He just jumps on the parrot and holds him in his paws. Push. Now I am going to eat you, parrot. You are a good cat. If you want to eat me, you must first wash your hands and face. That's what all good cats do. So here what parrot is telling to the cat? You are a good cat. If you want me, you want to eat me, you first wash your hands and face. That's all what good cats do. See how the parrot make the push fool. Just see how fast I wash my face and hands. You stand here and see. After that, push believed the parrot and he said to him, you stand here, I'll just wash my face and hands in a minute and I'll come. Parrot, I'm not going to wait for you to eat me up. Here I go. Bye bye, push. Wow, the parrot fooled the cat and push that I am not going to wait for you. Here I'll go. Bye bye, push. So from this story, what we have learned that we should not believe easily to anybody, isn't it? We should not believe easily to anybody. Whatever the people are saying, we'll try to listen and try to think of our own brain, right? We'll think for a while with the brain. Is that person is telling the right thing to do or the wrong thing to do? Is that person is correct for me? This and that. We will all think like this. Okay. So that if any accident occurs in future, we will be safe from that. Right. Or that will be a lesson for us, that we will not believe that person or that type of person forever, right? isn't it? So I hope you all people enjoyed this story. The story is very enjoyable, lovable, and it's not boring at all. Okay, I had made you understood in my own words, small words. And if you want to ask me, you are most welcome. You can ask me 1,000 times. Okay. So we will complete the next coming worksheets or question answers in our next segment. Okay, till then, bye, take care, have a nice day, and listen to your parents, obey your parents, respect your elders, respect your teachers, do your assignments in time, submit it, and study properly. Okay. Bye, students. Take care. Bye-bye.